Hi guys, welcome to WebSense Pro. Welcome to another Shopify tutorial video, and in this video I'll show you guys how you can add blocks on your thank you page and on your order status page. So this isn't something which is allowed via code, so Shopify doesn't give access to checkout pages like thank you page and order status page, but in this video I'm gonna show you guys a way how you can add the blocks. Like if you want to add icons, if you want to add static content or a little bit of dynamic content for free without using any code, and this is with the checkout blocks, which is a Shopify app, a free app which you can use to add content blocks on your thank you page and on your order status page. So if you want to learn, stick to the video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. I keep creating video to help you guys to improve layout of your Shopify store and increase your sales and average order value and CRO optimization, a lot of different kind of stuff you will learn in this channel. So make sure to subscribe this channel. So guys, this is the app which we'll be using, and I'm gonna install that on my development store and show you how it's gonna work. So it's basically the preview here within the screenshots here, and here you can see that this part of the thank you page is coming from our checkout blocks, and we will try to do something similar by installing that on our development store, right? And there are some of the features which are for Shopify Plus, which we won't cover here. So we can add these features like create custom order and shipping discount in Shopify Plus, validate address, hide rename and reorder delivery payment methods, stuff like that in Shopify Plus. It's not in the normal packages of Shopify. So let's install that app and see how it works. By the way, I'm creating this video without any preparation. So I just wanted to experience that. What is the feedback which I'm gonna get from you guys, that if I create videos without practicing prior to creating the videos. I'm going to explore this app myself with you guys in this video. Okay, so let's start creating the video. And before we proceed, I would like you to request, guys, that we have created an app for increasing the average order value for you guys, for improving your sales of e-commerce stores. So this app is gonna add the volume based discount or a tier based discount if you want to offer that to your customer. It will help you a lot. We got this feedback from a lot of comments from you guys and a lot of merchants which we have worked with, and we have created like more than 50 plus stores right now, and 30 to 40 of them are currently our customers which use us for customization and a lot of other stuff. And that's the app, and it's just $2 a month, $1.99 a month, and free trial is also available. So make sure to try that out and see if it helps you increase your sales and average order value. Try it out. Other than that, you can simply install the app. Link will be in the description, so make sure to check that out. Okay, now let's start implementing our content blocks on the order status page, on the thank you page. And this is the app. Link will be in the description. You can simply Google that as well. It's apps.shopify.com/checkoutblocks. You can simply Google Shopify checkout blocks. Okay, I've already installed that app on my development store, and this is how it looks when you go to that app. We have checkout blocks and blocks. Now let's first try creating a static checkout block to see how it works. Let's click on create block. And here you can see that we have option of dynamic content and we have option of static content. Let's first try creating static content to see how it works, and then we will go to dynamic content and see how that's gonna work. Let's do that. Okay, open editor, and it simply says that you can go to checkout blocks and add in the static content. Configure block setting if needed. Okay, now let's open the editor to see how our static content works. Okay, so here we are on our checkout page, and if I click on static content plus sign here, and I'm gonna add it on let's do that on order status page, and this is our order status page, and that's how our order status page looks like, right? And here you will be adding some content, whatever you want to add in. So here we have these options. So let's try adding sub box. What's that? Let's try first doing the plain text. Test static content checkout block. Okay, in description font size, we have these options to change the font size. I'm gonna make it small. Alignment, start, set, end, description, font appearance. So it's pretty simple and pretty basic. Show collapsible. Okay, we also have the option to make it look like a drop down if we want to, right? Perfect. And if it's selected as false, it's gonna look like that. And yeah, so it's pretty simple to add in the static content. Now let's try the dynamic content to see how it works. And that's our order status page. I'm also going to test it once we add the dynamic content as well on the actual order status page. So let's do the dynamic content now. And now let's do the dynamic content. Here I'm going to select dynamic content. And here we have option of these support buttons, which you can see you can add. You can add this banner type surface. You can also add FAQ accordion. Let's try adding the FAQ accordion. And let's name it accordion example. Title is optional. So I'm just gonna name it accordion to see how it works. And here we have this accordion. So let's edit this to see what are we gonna showing. Okay, here we have the title of the first accordion. And this is something which is used for the content. Insert, return, and exchange. Accordion text insert link. We can also add link. Perfect. Personalize. Okay, we can also add here the dynamic fields, like if you want to show the name of the customer. Here we can display the name of the customer. Here we can display first name, last name, email. So let's try that out as well. I'm just going to add in name to see if it works fine. Name, email. So it's a great way to customize the message which you're gonna show on the checkout or on your order status page, right? So you can customize that based on the customer who is actually ordering. I think that's fine. A name and email. Okay, here we have some icons which we select. Shopify icon, no icon. Okay, icon type, clock. So here are the different type of icons which we can show. Here we have this clock, arrow right. Let's do arrow right. Auto expand. Let's see what's that. So now how many items do we have? So that's the first, and that's the second item, and that's the third item which we have. So okay, JavaScript are not supported. We cannot add the code here. So it's already mentioned that we cannot add CSS, HTML, and JavaScript. Let's see what's in the documentation. Examples of snippets using Liquid, supported Liquid variables. Okay, we have these variables which we can use. Checkout item count, checkout marketing, okay. Customer liquid variables, localization liquid variables, order liquid variables. Perfect. So we can display all of these items on these blocks. You have used list, right? Perfect. Okay, now let's proceed further. Okay, we can also add more tabs here. And let's see how many tabs which we can add. I think we can add a lot of tabs, a lot of accordions. Okay, I think it's unlimited that how many tabs which we can add. Let's delete the ones which are empty. It was just for the testing purpose that how many accordions which we can add. Okay, that's it. Now icon color monochrome XN default. Perfect. Let's click on done and try adding that on our order status page. Click on save. Okay, now let's try adding that on our order status page. Guys, before we add it to our order status page, I want to let you know that if you are a new to Shopify and you are a new merchant and you want your store to set up for just $1 a month, there's a link in the description. If you sign up through that link, you will get your store with just $1 a month. So what are you waiting for? Make sure to sign up through that link, link in the description. Okay, now let's proceed with adding this accordion to our order status page. Okay, all blocks. So these are dynamic blocks. Okay, its status is draft, so I'm gonna make it active. So here's the status, and let's make it active. Perfect. Now let's add it to our order status page. Okay, we also have the display rules. That's really cool. So we can display that conditionally if we want to. Currently it's displaying to all of the customers, but we can add the display rule that if it's a specific product, okay, we can select the product, any single item, all line items. Okay, we can also select the product that if we want to display that based on the product in the cart or the checkout, how many, okay, line item has selling plan, if we, it's a subscription product, right, also known as line item attribute, product meta field. Okay, we can trigger it based on the meta field as well. Perfect. The meta field must use namespace of checkout blocks and a key of trigger. Okay, right, perfect. So we will need to create a meta field which is using the namespace of checkout blocks and a key of trigger. So checkouts dot trigger, and it's going to match the text from that meta field and going to show our content block based on that condition. Cool. It's going to display that based on cart currency, based on cart total, based on cart attributes. A lot of options here. Like we can also do that on based on customer language. Really cool. So we have a lot of options here for conditionality that we can display that based on those conditions. Perfect. Now let's try adding that on our order status page. So here we are again on the theme editor. I'm going to click on this plus for dynamic content, and I'm going to add it to order status page. Okay, now here you can see that we have this accordion showing up. So on top we have the static content and below that we have dynamic content. Let's see if we can change the position. Okay, if we click on that, and okay, yes, we can change the position as well. So you can see here this up arrow and this down arrow, so we can change the position here as well. That's cool, right? And okay, so why it is asking for the app block ID? Okay, so we can add 10 blocks, right? And we can set the conditionality based on this option which we have here, the display rules. We can have multiple display rules for multiple blocks, and this is for the testing purposes. So if there is condition is not meeting and we want to preview that block, we are just gonna simply select the ID of that block and paste the block ID, and block ID is showing up here. So that's our app block ID, right? So we can add 10, 11 actually blocks in our checkout page. That's cool. Okay, now if I open this, you can see that it's showing name and email. And I'm gonna place the test order to see if it actually shows my name, to see how it works. Let's add in a test order to see if it works. I'm gonna add it. By the way, guys, if you're looking at this development store, I have really cool sections which I have created, this product page slider, this person discount badge, custom badge, this testimonial slider thing, and I have also had this circle menu, this auto loop video, a lot of different sections which I have created in this channel and which are available completely for free. So all you have to do is just subscribe my channel and watch the video for free and improve the layout of your store. Okay, we were adding the test order. Okay, let's get back to that. The test order, buy it now. Okay. Credit card. Perfect. Now let's click on Pay Now to see if our checkout blocks are showing up. Okay, this is our thank you page, and we added that on our order status page, right? Where does the order status page shows up? Let's try doing that on our thank you page customer accounts. Okay, we'll have to log into our customer account and go to the order status page to look at it, right? Let's add into the thank you page. Okay. Publish. Click on publish again. Perfect. Our thank you page is published. I'm gonna add in our app block, which is for dynamic content. Let's add in the dynamic content. And here we are. Our dynamic content is showing up. Let's move it up. Perfect. Our accordion is showing up. Click on save. Now, if I go to my thank you page and hit refresh, log in to view all order detail. What's that page? Let's add in another test order to see, because I'm not sure which page is this. Okay, let's add in another order. Okay, let's do the bank deposit this time. It's not placing the order. Perfect. Let's click on complete order. Okay, let's do the credit card. It's not taking the order. Again, guys, this video is not prepared video. So just wanted to see how is the feedback which I'm gonna get from you guys. So let me know in the comments below if you like this unprepared video of mine. And here we go. You can see that our dynamic content is showing up. And if I click on it, it's showing my name and my email, right? And delivery time. So we can add the text on this app. Cool. And I think that's it, guys. It's that simple to add dynamic content and static content on your order status page and on your thank you page using the checkout blocks app. And hopefully you will like this video, and let me know in the comments below what more you would like to learn in Shopify. Until next video, have a great day.